Okay, we are here with our final two, minus a few jury members, but we have everyone else that has made it to jury here tonight. So what we're going to do for final tribal council is that we're going to have our finalists plead with our opening statements, and then when we're done, we're going to get right into questions and then get into votes. So let's start things off. Ladies first, Miranda, start us up.
I want to say thank you for applying and playing this game. I really enjoyed playing with all of you and getting to know all of you. How my game went was at the beginning, the very beginning, day one, I made an alliance with Christian, Kevin, Turner, and myself. And that's what protected me the first part of the game, was having that tight alliance where we covered each other's back. And when it came to the tribal just before merge, I realized that I had my back up against the wall, because I was gunning to get Paige out personally because she had been so inactive. And I'm about keeping the tribe strong. And I was at the time with Brogan and Sebastian, and they were protecting her. So I knew that there are some deeper alliances that I wasn't a part of. And so I needed to do what I needed to do to stay in the game. So coming down to the last tribal before merge, I want immunity. And Christian was voted out. I guarantee if Christian would have gotten that immunity, I would have been gone and I wouldn't have even made merge. So going into merge, day one, I knew that I wanted to talk to Anthony and I knew I wanted to talk to Jim. They were the ones that I had not played with yet and the ones I wanted to talk to and get to know and try to build some kind of alliance, friendship, anything. Because it was me. All that was left for Basami was myself. So I needed somebody somewhere to work with me. That first day of merge, Dan, Anthony, and Kevin, the four of us formed an alliance, and we decided from there on, we are playing together, we're gonna cover each other's back, and we're gonna do this thing together. Coop knew he was on the line, and he came running, trying to form this alliance. He just thought he'd form this big alliance to cover himself, because he knew he was going out. So it worked good for the four of us, because we had another number for us. He thought it was for him, but it was the four of us that came together to work together. And Pook, you think we're goats, but you were a number for us, and I really enjoyed playing with you. And the four of us stuck together all the way to Final Four, to Final Three, to now me and Anthony sitting here. And if you have any questions on gameplay, I'm more than happy to answer any questions that you have, or if you have any comments, like, I'm here to take them. I'm here to take them on.
Okay. Anthony, close us out.
Hey, guys. So first, congratulations to Miranda for making it to the final two. I'm happy that we're both sitting here together. So for me, like, my journey started before the game even, like, we even started the game. I remember talking to Josh and Darcy about how I used to play in these really primitive Survivor orgs back in 2004 when I was in college, and I actually did pretty well. I won my first four games ever there, and I felt like, you know, that was a time of, you know, all-stars, and I won by creating a loyal alliance and just, you know, kind of being the de facto leader. And I was really worried that coming into this game, I wasn't going to be good with the new school strategy, and that's what got me voted off. Like, I knew right away that Sebastian, Molly, and Brogan had a pregame alliance. It was so obvious. What I didn't know was that Brogan and Madison knew each other, you know, before the game. So that was one wrench I didn't really figure out. So my fatal mistake was I was being too vocal about it. I wanted Brogan out. I pushed it. I pretty much demanded it from Sebastian and Madison, which turned them, you know, against me. And as you guys know, you ethically blindsided me. When I went to Stranded Island, I was determined. Now, you guys have to keep in mind, like, I am working from home. I'm stuck in this apartment 24 hours a day with just my dog. So this is a really good outlet for me. I probably put a lot of energy into it, maybe too much energy, honestly. But I was determined to come back in this game with two objectives. It was A, to make the finals, and B, to outlast every single person who put my name down at that joint tribal council. And as you can see, I actually achieved both of my objectives. I know that, you know, when I came back in the game, I had a huge target on my back. Nobody wanted to work with me. I had to do what I had to do. I had to lie cheat, steal. I had to make a plan A, a plan B, a plan C. I had to know who to go to, and that was Harmony and Dan on the Rolodone tribe, and kind of get my way in. I had to, you know, I poached the idea about making fake idols to get Harmony to save me just one round. Dan actually made the idol, but I was the one who poached the idea. I was making fake, you know, chats to people, so, you know, they'd think that I was, you know, with them, so I could keep the target off me. And I still didn't think that I was going to go far. When I made that alliance with Miranda, well, Dan and I made an alliance with Miranda and, you know, Kevin, day one, we were still in four people. And the turning point for me was when Pook and Jim came to us about voting out Brogan. And for me, that was a no-brainer. If I would have stuck with Sebastian, Madison, and Brogan, like, I would have gotten at best ninth place. Like, I did what I had to do. And then from there, once Madison was out of this game, sorry, my dog was going at it. Once Madison was out of this game, like, the target was off of me. Like, I never, ever got in a situation after that where my name was even brought up. And I think that I had done such a good job when I got to the final five. I had a final two with Molly. I had a final two with Dan. I had a final two with Miranda. I had a final two with Kevin. I had plan A, B, C, and D to where I think that I didn't even need immunity at the final tribal council. I was going no matter what I did. Now, granted, I wanted to control my own fate, but I think that I played really hard, and I just ask that you guys take the personal relationship and the strategic, you know, nature of this game, and you separate it, because the personal connections I made were genuine. I had to make the moves I had to make to get myself here, or no way in hell would I be sitting here. So I look forward to your questions, your criticism, your whatever you want to throw at me. Bring it and I'll be happy to answer it.
Okay. Thank you, Anthony and Miranda. So here's what we're going to do. One at a time, I will address from the earliest jury member to get voted up to the latest to answer all their questions. Because Molly has to leave quickly, I will address to her question first. So keep in mind, everybody, as a reminder, no personal attacks, only just straight up asking questions on strategically gameplay. Now, one thing that has been addressed in regards to Anthony swearing on his mom's grave kind of aspect, the only kind of, if anybody has any questions towards that, only strictly towards gameplay. Any kind of personal attack directed towards that, you will be removed from the Zoom call. Clear? Okay. Molly, because you have to go first, go ahead.
Thank you, I appreciate that. Well, first of all, congratulations, you guys. Yeah, I think you both played a good game. I respect you both for making it this far. That being said, I do have a couple questions. One question, I guess. Anthony, I have a question for you. So, the night that I went home, were you ever going to, if Dan had not won individual immunity, would you have nullified him? Or was it always going to be me?
Absolutely, Molly, it was going to be Dan. That was, honestly, that was the first time that I even thought about turning on Miranda. The reason I didn't was because Miranda gave me the coins to buy that nullifier. So I was like, damn, that's really brutal. And it came down to you and Miranda. And for me, it was, you had a lot of friends on the jury. And that's the only reason that I nullified you.
Understandable. I respect that completely. And I take it as a compliment. Miranda, I don't really have a question for you, I guess. Honestly, I don't see any huge moves that you made throughout the game, but I will respect your game, and I'm not going to bash either of you in any way. So just congrats on making it this far, and we will see. And I got to go, guys, but I'll watch this later. I'll watch when it's all posted. So
thanks,
good luck,
Molly,
to you both.
Thanks, Molly.
Bye, guys.
Okay, Molly, submit your vote in.
I will.
All right, bye-bye.
Bye.
Okay, thank you, Molly. Now we're gonna go in order this time. So we'll start with Brogan. Brogan is not here, but he submitted his question. So Anthony, this is directed towards you. And keep in mind, this question is about the swearing on your mother's grave, but you don't have to answer that if you don't want to, but I'll say it pretty much anyways. So here's the question. He said, He said, my question for Anthony is simple. Explain why I should give you my vote after you swore on your mother when you went back on your word for multiple people.
The only time that I remember doing that, and again, there's a lot of game confusion, was when I told Madison and Sebastian that I wasn't against them. in my opinion. That round I wasn't against Madison and Sebastian. I was against Brogan for sure. I don't recall swearing on my mom, especially after the Sebastian and me incident, ever wanting to use that again. But for me, it's a game. And if that means people trusted me, so be it. Is it something that I'm proud of? No. Do I think my mom's burning in hell because of it? Absolutely not. She's probably laughing at me for being such a dumbass. So I knew I had to be bold and the way I played the game. And if that's what got me further, then that's what I had to do.
Okay. We'll go to Madison. Madison does not have a question. She's currently in recruitment right now. So next up, we'll go in order, is Sebastian. Remember, no personal attacks. Go ahead.
Yes, of course. So I know everyone thinks my vote is already set. I want to let you guys know that is not the case. I just want to address that. I mean, it doesn't even matter at this point. My question for Anthony is, if you were able to do this over again, would you use those same tools that you used to excel? Because the thing is you look at it as a game move. And the way I see it is, most people, there's just kind of like a moral code, which is not a rule, anyone can do it, that you don't do that. And I think any single one of us could have sworn a lot of really close things to us to get us further than we did. So if you were to do it again, would you use the same tools to excel yourself, or would you try to switch it up?
So I think that's a two-part question. The first part of the question is, I never started the game being like, I'm gonna lie on my mom just for the sake of lying on my mom. It came down to, like, when I lied to you and Madison, like, I was being serious. Like, because at that point, you know, yeah, I had the four, we were just four people. I had not talked to Poop, I had not talked to Jim. I needed something that was gonna keep me in this game. And for me, if that meant working with you, then that's what I was gonna do. When I had the option with Pook and Jim, I knew that was the better option for my game because it made Pook and Jim feel like they were in charge, and it let me, Miranda, Dan, and Kevin really kind of control this game. So for you, I apologize that, you know, it got so kind of twisted. Like, my intention was never to lie to you about my mom for the sake of the game. Like, I actually, before you guys blindsided me, I enjoyed talking to you. Like, that still stands. I know that there was a lot of bad blood between you and I in this game, but I want you to know that it's a game. I don't take it personal. If I don't get your vote, that's fine. But one of the biggest things that I hated about this game, because I am a competitor, is when you quit. Because I knew you had at least one idol, and I didn't know you had two. I wanted to go head-to-head with you. And if you beat me, then so be it. You beat me. If not, then here I am. So, I mean, I don't know what else you want from me. I mean, I know that, you know, Dan was showing me screenshots where you're saying that I was, you know, an ugly wart that kept growing back, that I was gonna win All-Stars because everybody hated me. Like, when I see those screenshots, Sebastian, what am I supposed to do? Be like, damn, Sebastian hates me. Like, I need to actually just do what he says because I swore on my mom. Like, that was the issue I had, was do I go back on this word, or do I know right now this guy is not going to work with me? Like, he's going to use me and then discard me. Or do I make my own fate in this game? And I wanted to make my own fate in this game, and I did. That's what it comes down to.
And I just want to make it clear, I was never upset at you for flipping on me, because that's part of the game. I just felt like, as someone, because we were friends in the beginning, so when you get on the phone and just like look so sad, like, of course, I'm the type of person where I felt bad, and I knew you were trying hard to be there. So like, to use those things on top of that is ultimately what really set me off. I will apologize specifically for the burning comment, because I've said it in my confessional, I've told plenty of people that was way too far. I didn't need to word things like that and come so viciously. It came out of me being hurt. And I guess we'll just see what happens. Thank you for your answer. So Miranda, I need you to list a couple moves that you did on your own. Because honestly, I tried really, really hard to work with you in the beginning. I know you say you were on your own, but I literally tried to talk to you. You wouldn't even try to negotiate on the Turner vote. So if you're just gonna like my comments and leave me unread, I'm just gonna do what I wanna do with my life. So because of that, we just haven't really been able to play together. I don't know what your game is. So illuminate that, because I think a lot of people are just really looking for, like, what did Miranda really do to give it to her?
Okay, so I appreciate your question. At the beginning of the game, again, I made my four alliance with Kevin, Turner, and Christian. I knew going into that tribe, it was three Basami, three Ruudon, and two Myga, or two Myga, or three Myga, two Ruudon. Anyways, so I wanted to try and keep it like the 3-3 and go for the minority of the two. No one was interested. Alliances had already been made that I was not a part of. And I couldn't, on my own heart, I could not vote Turner. I couldn't. And so that's why I did not vote Turner, and I knew Turner was gonna go home, but for my own sake, for my own heart, I could not. And so going on from there, I knew that there was alliances that I was not a part of, and so that's why I was trying harder in talking with you more, and I was talking with Rogan more. And unfortunately, between you and I and me and Rogan, we talked more life. We talked more personal things than actual gameplay. And I mean, I tried, I was trying, but there was no give in information. There was no give in wanting to work with me. And I mean, I can't force that. So going on from there, like I even said to Brogan, I'm like, why don't we vote out Paige? And like, she seems like she's in a lot of games. She can't keep up. Let's just, you know, vote her out and keep our tribe strong because she's not showing up. And nobody wanted to listen to that either. And so at that point, I knew like my vote was on Paige that round again. And you guys voted out Christian. And if I wouldn't have won immunity that round, I would have been gone. Like, no matter what Broken says, like, you're safe, we have your back, whatever. It was like, you did it. You wanted the Basami gone. And so I won immunity, I held out, and I won immunity to get into merge. Going into merge, again, I was scrambling. I had no one. Kevin had not battled back yet. It was me, myself. I messaged Molly, I messaged Madison, I messaged everybody, and I got nothing. I got nothing after that. So when I reached out to Anthony, and me and Anthony clicked like that because we both knew we needed each other, from then on, we created our plan. Dan came into the play and he was awesome. We wanted to work with Dan because we trusted Dan. And Kevin. Kevin battled back and we're like, yes, we have four. We can move on from here. And I didn't talk as much with Dan and Kevin as I did with Anthony, but me and Anthony planned every move together. Post-merge, I had every single vote right. I will say, but there's one vote that I did not vote the right person, but it was supposed to go how we had planned. I had talked to Molly in Harmony, and we were gonna vote out Pook. I told them that you guys were splitting the votes on Molly and Harmony. They told me they had idols. I told them to use their idols. Unfortunately, Kenji did not show up and Pook stayed. So Pook was supposed to go that round. Unfortunately, Kenji wasn't there. So, I mean, regardless, every single vote, I had it right post-merge. I was in on it. I helped plan it. I helped execute it. You guys thought of me as a goat. You saw me as just a little mommy at home. Jim kind of, I felt like he was treating me like a daughter. And I'm going to let you guys do that. If that's what you think I am, that I can't plan these things, that I can't be a part of it, go ahead and think that. I'm still going to make it to the end because I had who I needed to on my corner to get me there.
Thank you. And then I just want to address for the cast one thing is just me leaving. Anthony is right. I had two idols when I left. I had traded Paige and idol for the two advantages that I gave to Dan. And truth be told, it was she quit, she would have gave me one. I would have had three. And you can ask Harmony. I was just having a really hard time. I told her, I'm like, dude, I'm breaking down. Like, this is miserable. And she begged me to stay, and it worked for one day. And honestly, it was other things too. And I did leave. I don't want anyone to feel at blame for that specifically. I know a lot of things got lost in translation, and I portrayed myself in a way that it's not something I normally do. I'm sorry that most of you saw the ugly side that can come out of me. I really do wish the best for everybody, genuinely, and good luck to Final Tribal, and may the best person win.
Thank you.
Sebastian. Can't hear you, Josh.
Sorry. We will now screen share for Paige's video. Can you guys see it?
Yep.
Okay, here it goes.
Hey guys, first off, I want to say congratulations making it to the final tribal. That is fucking huge. You should be so proud of both of yourselves. And I'm so, oh, it's my daughter, sorry. I'm really sorry that I had to quit the game and that I didn't get to finish with you guys, because it would have been fun to see how far I would have made it. But yeah, Congratulations to both of you. Quick question. I want you to define what jury management means to you and how you apply that to me, per se. Because I feel like jury management is a huge part of the game, and without it, you're not going to get any votes. So define it for me. Tell me how you used it in, you know, like with me. And yeah, good luck. Congratulations to both of you. And my vote's up in the air. So whoever played the best game will get my vote. Bye.
Okay. We'll start with Anthony.
So jury management is crucial in this game, and I feel like, you know, obviously I pissed off a lot of people. But again, that goes back to, I don't feel like I had a choice. I mean, I kept trying to get something to go with Harmony, and every time I did, she'd run back and tell somebody else what I said. She gave me a coin to buy an advantage and then told everybody that I had an advantage. Like, there was no Anthony's gonna, like, you know, just skip along to the end, because nobody wanted to work with me. And the people that did, like Pook, I mean, Pook was screenshotting his whole life to everybody. So I put it in Miranda's head, I put it in Dan's head, I put it in, you know, Kevin's head, even Jim's head, like, hey, he's really kind of a loose cannon. Like, is this someone that we really want to keep long term? I put the target off me. Jim, you know, I really enjoyed my, you know, relationship with Jim, but Jim would have won this game 100% if I didn't put him on the jury. I bought that sit out challenge advantage just to put Jim on the jury. And that is the God's honest truth. It wasn't personal. I put the target off me and put him on him. So I did a lot of lying, but the only way that I could get myself to the end was to do that. I mean, I had a final two with Dan and it crushed me to vote him out, but he had the resume because he was giving us all the information. At that time, I didn't know what else to do but to play my face off and hopefully everybody could come back, you know, reflect on my game and be like, damn, like, his back was really against the wall and he overcome huge odds. Yeah, he lied and cheated and stealed, but he wouldn't be here if not. And that's just the bottom line. So as far as Paige is concerned specifically, you know, I wanted to save Paige the damn round I went home. Like, that's what got me freaking out of the game. So Paige was someone that I definitely respected and I liked, but, you know, she was inactive and it was hard to make anything go with her, and everything she said to me was a lie because I was getting screenshots to show the opposite of what she was saying to me. So it was hard to trust her. I didn't feel like she was a threat to my game as big as, you know, Sebastian, Madison, Pook, Jim, Jan. But, you know, so she was kind of like a, you know, she wasn't a detriment or a help to my game. So it, honestly, for me, her quitting didn't have any effect.
Miranda.
I find it interesting that Paige is wanting to know about jury management when she wasn't there for challenges, she wasn't there for tribals, and she didn't comment back in conversations. Like, how can I manage a relationship when there isn't one? Again, I've commented to her, I've responded to her, I've tried to engage with her, and I got nothing. And so it's just interesting, like, I know she's a mother, but so am I, and I'm here with my kids just like she is, and I was still able to be here for every challenge, every tribal, committed 100%. So, I mean, I don't know. I just, you can't have jury management with someone who's not there, is what I'm saying.
Okay, and speak of the devil, Paige submitted in her vote. We will now go down to Kenji.
Oh my god, it's me. Okay. I don't want to ask a question, actually. I just want to congratulate and I am very proud of you because I love playing with both of you. You're gorgeous people. Anthony, you're very, very awesome. Miranda, you're so beautiful and gorgeous. I'm very happy to know you guys, each and every one of you in this game. And I'm very, very happy to everybody. Like, I'm so happy that even though I was struggling, but you're just lucky that I slept on my truck when I got voted out, because I'm sure I'm the one who's sitting there, not you guys. And congratulations. And my vote will be, it's already fixed, but I wish everybody's doing well. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Kenji.
Love you.
Love you, girl.
Thank you, Kenji. Pook. But okay, so first of all, let's talk about acronyms. Miranda, GOATs, greatest of all time. Maybe that's what I was calling you. Maybe I wasn't calling you the other kind of GOAT. So check yourself. Anthony, I have a couple questions for you. Yeah. We had a plan to get you out right away, and it worked out swimmingly. You went away, and as soon as you did, I knew it was a mistake, because I knew that I could carry you in my pocket as long as I wanted. And I didn't realize until you got back that you were a lot smarter than I gave you credit for. And I realized that me, you, and Jim could make something happen to where we could flip the game on its head. And that's where we did with Brogan. Now, you say that you were using me as a number, Miranda, but if it wasn't for my number with Jim and our advantages and our idols and this and that, you wouldn't be here right now, because you didn't make any moves like people are saying that, you know, asking you for. You haven't said anything that has been an actual move that is that impressive. Now, you did help us do certain things. Dan has a lot of credit, because Dan was playing double agent the whole time. I knew I wasn't going to make it to the end. My only chance was going to that battle back when Dan actually was the one that voted me out. I'm going to give him the credit for that one, even though you guys had it too. I thought that I could win this battle back, but I didn't. And I knew if I did that, then it was game over. Me and Jim would have taken it to the end, and it would have been a wrap. But things happened, and I suck. And so I got, you know, screwed myself. But Anthony, do you think that you would be at the end right now if you wouldn't have joined in on the six people that we had? Do you think that if you would have stayed with the people that you originally had, you would have made it further than you are right now?
Absolutely not. I mean, I think that I was a lot more part of the decision-making than you're giving me credit for. But no, if you and Jim did not come to us, there's no way in hell that I'd be sitting here. So point blank period, no. Like, I wouldn't be here. Like, that was the turning point of my game. That's why I got so excited during the tribal council. Not because I was happy that Brogan was going. Yeah, I was against him, but it's because the plan worked. And not only that, but you guys played a Bermuda idol on me when I had two idols in my pocket. So I was like, yes, I'm safe, and I have two idols. So, no. I mean, point blank, no. I wouldn't have made it if I didn't link up with you guys.
I mean, but I knew that, you know, you worked your ass off, and you got voted out. You won your way back. Same with Kevin. I mean, Miranda, I don't know if she made a good decision taking you to the end, but if she would have brought Kevin to the end, I mean, it might have been a downfall as well. I love you, Miranda, with everything, but you know, the question to you is, I mean, we've already tried to get people to say, what were your moves, what was this, what was that, but you haven't really said what the move was. You said that you were involved in it, but you never said that you actually pushed it forward. I mean, you're talking about me being a number, but I mean, were you just the number in those moves, or were you like the conductor of the train? Because I think that you were more of the caboose than the engine, you know what I mean? So is there a move that you pushed forward yourself?
Yes. When it came down to the gym vote, I had my steal a vote and I had a burn a vote. I used my burn a vote on Molly and I stole, or my burn a vote on Jim and I stole Molly and Jim went home. That was my move. I told you guys the whole time, I'm like, I'm playing poor Miranda, and you got, like, I told you what I was doing, and you still thought I was just this poor little Miranda just playing along. No, I was strategizing the entire time.
That's not what we thought. We thought that you were a really integral part of what we had going the whole time, actually. The stuff that we all talked about was actually real stuff. You know, we had this whole thing that was misconstrued with my persona I put on, and, you know, everybody came and thought that I was this crazy creepy person, which I might be, fuck, I don't know, but it's not exactly who I am all the time. And
what was my response to that, Pook?
Yeah, your response was great because you jumped on board, but hearing you now, it wasn't legit, so I don't know about it. But you know,
I was never a part of the Pook is gross.
Oh, I know that.
I was never uncomfortable with you ever.
I know that, and that's okay. That what I'm trying to say is that there was, you know, the cool kids side of it is what we called everybody.
I don't know who gave him the name. It was probably Dan.
Both of us.
But, you know, the kids that were the cool kids that we had all the problems with, it kind of started with, you know, just being pointed at how they felt about me in the situation. But all of them are actually really good people. All of them are actually great at the game. And if we didn't make the moves we did, they would be absolutely winning this. Because they were at the bottom from the beginning.
I just want to address one thing. Everyone thinks that me, Brogan, and Madison were in together pregame and that we were unbreakable. One is I was cool with Brogan because we just got off India together. I had never met Madison. Brogan told Madison that I was going to win. They had to cut me. And Brogan told me he wanted Madison out at 7. And Madison and Brogan have been friends since like elementary school, which none of us knew.
Yeah.
Well, we did know. We did know later on because Anthony kind of spilled the beans on.
Well,
that
Dan told me, and I told everybody. Dan told me, and I told everybody.
No, but hey, my last thing is like, you guys, this game was crazy. I've never played in a game with this many advantages, twists, turns, and crazy people all in one, and it turned out to be awesome. I mean, it did. I genuinely like all you guys. Anthony kind of sucks still, but you're all right. I think my vote is probably pretty obvious right now, unless Anthony can.
Would you like to hear more of what I have to say?
No. My vote's for you right now. I need Anthony to pick up his game a little bit before this is over. But yeah, congratulations, guys. You guys did great.
Would you like to hear more of what I have to say?
Nope. Moving on. No, good job, guys. Honestly, it was a fun game. I'm glad we all got to do it together.
Okay, thank you, Pooh. And may I remind everybody that Season 1 had a lot more crazier twists than this, so this one was actually toned down. Thank God. Okay, we'll go next to Christian, who is not here but submitted his vote in, so we will go to Jim.
Well, hello there.
Hi, Jim.
So, first off, congratulations. That's fantastic. Everybody that is a fan of this game would love to be sitting in the chairs you're sitting in right now. So, me included. Excellent play, excellent job. Miranda, you kind of got my attention a little bit when you said you thought I was treating you like a daughter. Can you elaborate on that for me, please?
Whenever we talked, you're like, well, whatever you want to do. Don't make them use your advantages if you don't want to. Like, it was more of a protective than a working with me.
So you would think that as treating you like a daughter rather than working with somebody that I respect with morals?
We did talk about that. We talked about playing the game with a level head, and I agree. Like, I respect you 100%, and I know that you respect me, but I felt like how I was viewed as was just the little mommy at home who lets just use her vote, where I had been strategizing the whole time and working with it. Like, Anthony knew my every move. Anthony knew everything. And when it came to you, you were more cautious, kind of touching around the edges, like you wasn't really sure what to say. And I felt it was more cautious and protective rather than getting down to it and getting into the dirty and like talking about it and getting after it.
Real quick. You keep saying that Anthony knew everything. Anthony knows what he's saying. You're giving Anthony all this credit that you shouldn't be doing right now. You're trying to beat him in this game. But you have admitted this whole time with everybody that Anthony knew this, Anthony knew that, Anthony. Obviously, what you're doing is making Anthony's game seem incredible, which it absolutely was. Stop doing that right now. Punk his ass and make you look better than him, or else he's going to win the game. That's all I'm saying.
Remember, he brought you here too, so like, that's important to think about as well.
Yeah. So, for me to just shut that door real quick, I treat everybody the same. Guy, girl, it doesn't make a difference. You guys all know who I am now. There's no hidden secrets, this and that. Everybody has a little evil side that they can unleash. I just choose not to. And that's the decision I make. After hearing you both talking about these questions right now, you guys are both kind of attacking the jury that's picking $1 million for you, basically. You know what I mean? And it's mind-boggling to me how that's happening. So As Jeff would say, I've got nothing for you. We'll go to the next person.
Thanks, Jeff.
Thanks, guys.
Oh yeah, let's go to the next person. Harmony.
All right, guys. Mine's simple. I needed to pick a number between 1 and 2,000.
Wow.
Somebody go.
1,117.
1,116. Okay. Classic question. We'll now go to...
Wait, is it like The Price is Right where they can't go over? Or is it just the closest? I'm just curious.
Well, Molly already addressed her question. We'll now go to Dan.
Ooh. How do I follow that? First off, congratulations to both of you. I have two questions for both of you. What was the defining moment of your season? And what was your strongest part of your game?
Miranda first.
So the defining moment of my game was winning immunity to make it to merge. If I wanted one immunity, I wanted to make it to merge to make the connections that I did to get here. And what was your second question?
What was the strongest part of your game?
Okay, the strongest part of my game was being social and talking with everybody. And also winning immunities. I won 3 immunities. I won the one to get me to merge, and I won the final 4 and the final 3 to get me to the seat.
Forgot to mention, I forgot about that one. So which means, Miranda, you're now tied with Jim with most immunity wins in the history of Survivor Pandemic alumni.
Thank you. And I'm also tied for going the longest without a vote as well.
That is true.
So the defining part of my game, that you're asking, right?
Wait, hold on. Does that mean Anthony has, like, the number one spot for the most times his name has been written down?
I think yours is. I think you have me beat, Pook.
Yes, it was.
I think Pook has me beat, though. He's got a lot, too.
I looked at the numbers. Anthony, you had a total of 17, while Pook had 13.
Ooh.
That's also because I lasted 5 more rounds than him, but still. So, Dan, so your question is, what was the defining part of my game?
Yeah, like, what was the defining moment of your season? Like, what would you say was, like, that was it? It like made
for,
it.
For me, it was getting voted out, because I don't think I would have played this hard if not. I came back wanting revenge, and I was going to do whatever it took to get there. If I didn't get voted out, I probably would have been out a round or two later. One of my dogs in the target bag. Don't do that. So that's part of it. The second part was, when I got back in, it was aligning with you, like making up with you, and you kind of sharing all the information with me, because I wouldn't have been able to get this far if I didn't have the intel that you provided. And the one last piece of that I really think helped me was making that fake idol to Harmony, because it really helped her sell the rest of the tribe to keep me one more round, which gave me the momentum to, I mean, I hate to say it, lie, cheat, and backstab to get here. So those are my defining moments, and I own it.
And my second question was, what was the best part of your game?
The best part of my game was aligning with both you and Miranda, because I knew that Miranda was on the bottom, and I knew that her and I were going to stick together no matter what. And I knew that her and I could work together and kind of figure out and kind of flip this game up. And you, obviously, we developed a really close friendship. You know, I'm not trying to kiss your ass. Like, I really hated voting you out, but I knew that if I didn't put you on the jury, you were going to beat me. And I got greedy and I wanted to win. So it was making that connections with Miranda and with you that really got me to where I'm here.
Well, congratulations to you both. I respect you both, like, a ton. I love playing with everybody in here. And that's it for me.
Thanks, Dan.
Thanks, Dan.
Dan, Kevin, close us out.
All right. Well, congratulations to you both. I have a question for Miranda. We had a made an alliance. Actually, I made the alliance. I went to you first. I went to Turner and I went to Christian. So for you to take credit of making that alliance, I don't appreciate that. But we had made an alliance on day one. So getting this far, we were like, yeah, we should have Basami all the way to the end because we were targets since we got to the merge. So I want to know, why did you pick Anthony over me when we had an alliance since day one? And yeah, so that really was really heartbreaking for me. I was really heartbroken that you did that to me. So I wanted to know why.
I knew this question was coming, and I'm sorry that I hurt your feelings. Like, I had no intentions of doing that. I didn't want to, but when you came back into the game at the merge, there wasn't necessarily a lot of communicating between us other than our alliance chat. Whereas I was talking more with Dan, like me and Dan had more conversations and me and Anthony had more conversations than what you and I ever had, like just the two of us, like working together. So I felt like I had worked closer with Dan and I had worked closer with Anthony. And it was just the deeper connection is why I picked Anthony over you. And I still loved playing with you and I loved working with you. And yes, you were the one that made that alliance day one. I didn't mean to take that if I did. I just said that there was an alliance day one. I didn't mean that I made that. It was Kevin. And we, when you came back, I knew that we needed to work together. And another move that I made to like keep the target off of myself was when Christian came back. It was very, very, very tempting to keep three Basami strong to continue in the game. But I knew if I kept Christian that Anthony would flip out and that Dan would flip out and Jim would flip out. They would be so paranoid about the three Basami that I was next. So I had to get rid of Christian, even though I love Christian and I love playing with him and we had that alliance. But to keep myself safe, I had to get rid of Christian again so I could stay undercover, under the radar, not on people's hit list.
All right. Well, it is also a two-way street, so you could have messaged me also anytime. Anthony, I don't really have any questions. I love you. We both came back from Stranded, and yeah, that's it. Just wanted to know that because, yeah, I was really sad. But so good luck to you both.
It was a pleasure, Kevin.
Okay. Thank you, jury members. I hope whatever you have gathered here tonight will implicate on your jury vote. So here's what we're gonna do. Everyone-
Wait, Josh.
Yes?
Do you wanna break it to everybody now? The game's not over. We're actually all going back in right now.
Let's go.
battle back challenge.
are we hitting the reset button?
Yeah. Sebastian, let's make an alliance. I'll never respect it.
All right, how about we just all vote out Dan first? I'll self-pick.
And me and Harmony, no one will suspect us working together, girl.
Anyways, this is going to be a fun reunion later on. But yeah, time to close this off. Everyone, submit your jury votes in to either Anthony or Miranda that you want to win the season of Survivor Pandemic the Virginia Tribe. Send your votes in now.
Good luck, Miranda.
Good luck to you too, Anthony.
Oh, you guys are all making me feel right now.
Oh, that's awesome.
Alright, congratulations to you both and best of luck. I'm submitting my vote now.
Okay, I have the votes. So, I am going to bring in the rest of the cast to go in for the reunion show as I reveal the votes.
It is. The emotions get so high in this shit. It's nuts.
They really do.
The game brings up everybody.
It does. It's awful. Any little thing that you can use to attack someone is like ammo.
Ammo.
Like, I'm make it very clear for you guys.
Go to Las Vegas with Sebastian. Let's go party, Sebastian. Like, forget everything. Let's go party.
Yeah, the reunion's gonna be better than the whole season. We're all gonna get along.
Yeah. I'd be wasted off one more.
No more. Well, I haven't drank in 2.5 years, so I'd be wasted quick.
Hey, but you guys have to admit, that one move that we pulled off with Brogan got sent home, the way he was holding his blanket, and then he just, his whole life dropped before him, and he just dropped it off. He just looked like this, the life drained from him. I loved it. That was the best time.
I was messaging Josh, I'm like, Josh, let me play my fucking safety without power, and he's like, nope. Super no.
Too late!
You're like, too late? Sebastian was just like, flat out devastated. I'm like, sorry.
Sebastian, I can't believe you had like 18 idols.
I know, right?
I'm so mad that I went and told you about that fake one and they turned into a real one. I knew because Miranda had the other fake one and she's like, I got a real idol. And I'm like, that son of a bitch got a real idol.
What happened? There's a whole situation where I was told that that idol was 100% valid by the host. So like usually they'd be like, I can't confirm. I don't know. He was like, that's for an idol. Because as soon as I
was like, we'll discuss that every
day.
Okay.
Jim.
The way it was handled was not really set up properly. So, on behalf of Sebastian and Miranda, I do.
I'm thankful.
Miranda told me that, and I was like, that son of a bitch has another idol.
I don't know how you guys got so many. That is insane.
That was given to me.
I had one coin the entire game. Nobody gave me their coin.
Dude, so many people gave me coins. Kevin, Harmony, Paige, Miranda, Christina, Kenji, Tristan. I was freaking rolling in it.
I had a lot of advantages, but I could never use them because I was always screwed. So I had to give everything I had away every time.
I give 6 coins to Anthony.
Damn.
And that's what got the sit out challenge.
I'm so sorry, Jim. I'm the reason why you sit out because I give him 5 coins.
Kenji was a bang. Kenji gave me 2 coins so I could give me and Madison a coin to buy a nullifier. So like, wait,
yeah. I was very generous. Like, I don't have any idols. I'm just giving my coins to everyone.
Well, Sebastian, what was great about the nullifier is that Dan showed me that you guys had it. That you and Madison had a nullifier, but nobody knew I had one. Like, I asked Harmony for coins for nullifier, and she's like, oh, damn, it's sold out. And I was like, yeah, I know. But I had it because Miranda gave me 3 coins, and Paige gave me 1 coin.
I paid for half of that, and you had it in your hand.
Yeah.
And in my head, I was like, they can pretend that there's only 2, but like, there's probably 3 of all these. Let's just be pretty too many advantages in the game. So I was like, there's no way there's just 2.
I only bought 1 advantage, 1, and it was steal a vote, and that was it. I was gifted an idol, and Dan had given me the burn a vote because he got Sebastian's burn a vote. So
I had this all planned because I knew that if you played 2 idols on yourself, even if you nullified me, it would only nullify one of the idols and I would still be saved. So that's why I always try to keep 2 on me at one time, because I knew at one point someone was going to try to nullify.
Oh yeah. And
the thing is, if I didn't waste an idol on Dan too that one time for no reason, like I would have had 4.
I'm like, not gonna lie, I was laughing. I was like, oh my god, he just wasted an idol on
me. I know, that was crazy. I can't believe that happened either. Like, wow, we didn't even have
Dan's performance was like, what? It was the best.
And okay, and save this for reunion.
And then I kept crying to Pook and Jim about playing the Bermuda idol on me when I had 2 idols in my damn pocket. Sorry, Miranda, I only had 1. I was
no, that was a good two. That was a good play though. We had to play it on you, me, and Jim, or else it would have been
fucked.
Yeah.
I had the idol I was voted out with when I came back in, and then Sharon and I pulled coins. And I bought an idol on Stranded. So I wasn't lying to you and Madison, Sebastian. I really did have an idol. It's just what I was selling you wasn't the idol. Wasn't a real idol.
You said you weren't against the 3 of us, that the idol was real, and that you hadn't told anybody about that plan.
Dirtbag.
I was going to say, so let's
But Sebastian, here's why. Like I told you, Dan was showing me screenshots where you were saying I was a damn wart, and that I was the most hated person. And
you were a cancer. That kept coming back to you, only because like when this like I'm not a fan of attorneys because like we all lied to get you out, and like then they bring you back with 2 immunities and a nullifier. It's like, what the fuck? Like, you're literally punished for
whatever. Yeah.
And I'm like, my back.
I wasn't against Brogan at first. I went to Brogan right at Berg and said, hey, Pook wants to get you out. And then Pook comes to me and I was like, well, I got to change course here because I am not going to get far with Brogan, Madison, and Sebastian. And Dan was showing me that. Freaking Madison was like, haha, let's vote him out.
All right. I know you guys, how much you guys want to keep talking about this game, which I absolutely love you guys to do that. But let's just announce who our winner for season.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about that. Shit.
All right. I have the votes in. So first off, I wanted to thank the entire cast members for applying and playing this game. It has been an honor to host every single one of you guys. You guys definitely made this season memorable.
Would you let us all back, though? At the same time,
stars. Just saying, you guys. There's quite a bunch of contenders. So, yeah, I will say this is that there has been a huge roller coaster of emotions going from start to finish. You guys fought tooth and nail to get yourselves where you are now. So, congratulations, every single one of you, especially Anthony and Miranda. You both,
yes,
in terms of stranded, in terms of not getting voted out. And in terms of outlasting your competitors. But there can only be one winner.
I wish I didn't sleep.
I have right here 12 votes. And these votes are for the winner. Keep in mind, if we have a tie, the viewing lounge has been voting on which person they think deserves.
Oh, wow.
I
didn't know that.
I have a question.
The viewing lounge is actually involved, I promised.
I have a question.
Not an actual point, which again, we will discuss that. But anyways, so.
Can I use my brain boat?
Hmm?
Can I use a burn boat?
Burn a boat?
No.
Burn a boat. The
viewing lounge does not have a burning boat. They have okay? They're the tiebreaker boat. Alright, here we go. First vote, Anthony. That's one vote, Anthony. Second vote, Miranda. One vote, Anthony. One vote, Miranda. Third vote, Anthony. That's two votes, Anthony. One vote, Miranda. Fourth vote, Miranda. We're tied. Two votes, Anthony. Two votes, Miranda. Fifth vote, Anthony. That's three votes, Anthony. Two votes, Miranda. Sixth vote, Miranda, tied again. Three votes Anthony, three votes Miranda. Seventh vote, Anthony. That's four votes Anthony, three votes Miranda. Eighth vote, Anthony. That's five votes Anthony, three votes Miranda. Ninth vote, Anthony. That's six votes Anthony, three votes Miranda. It takes seven to win. Tenth vote. And the winner of Survivor Pandemic, the Bermuda Triangle.
Wow,
thank you, guys.
Congratulations.
Miranda,
so great playing with you.
Miranda.
I love you.
You guys both killed it, honestly. But I really did a great job to you both.
Now, to break suspense on the tiebreaker vote, Miranda, you actually would have gotten that.
Damn.
Unfortunately, that wasn't the case. The vote was 9-3 for Anthony to win.
Congratulations.
I am really shocked. I thought you all should.
Alright, so stick around, you guys, for a reunion show because I have some awards to give out and for record the address. So, here we go.
Great.